acknowledge the Lord, nothing about this until such time. And we didn't want to surprise her. We didn't want to surprise her. So good evening again, and welcome to this celebration. I trust that we'll see some smiling faces this evening, and some happy faces this evening, because it said that it takes 14 muscles to smile, and it takes 72 to frown. So it is better for you to smile than to frown. And knowing Camille, Camille is a happy person, a joyful person, and a pleasant person. So if you have that unpleasant face, just wipe it off, throw it outside, and put on the pleasant one. You see me? At this time, it is just fitting for us to open in prayer, and I'm going to ask Mrs. Francis to take us, to pray for us at this time.
All right, shall we pray? Kindly bow your heads while we ask for the Lord's presence to be with us. Our Father, who art in heaven, truly, Lord, we are grateful to you for having brought us here this evening. We ask your Lord that you will bless this function, and most importantly, that you'll continue to bless Camille as she reached this very special milestone. We ask that everything that will be done this evening will be done in good order and according to your name. Guide and protect us, we pray, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Mrs. Francis. For anyone in this dispensation to live to see 50, it is a blessing. Put your hands together for 50. And we want to say, Camille, happy, after three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday.
Oh, there's enough sound in ourselves. Let us go again. One, two, three.
Happy birthday.
Yes. And it is so fitting to see her family, her sisters and nephews and niece here. And it's something that Camille want to happen in her life. And we wait until 50 to see it happen. And somebody sitting beside her. That is honored and privileged to celebrate 50 with Camille. You saw him face it, you saw him. You see. 50 and fabulous. Woo! 50 and strong.
Amen.
50 and gorgeous.
Oh, yes.
50 and nice. 50 and an uppin. 50 and a curl. 50 and ready for the video light. You see? Yes, Camille. You know, watch out. She does not. Watch out. Watch out. Watch out. You see? So, ladies and gentlemen, 50 years, and I can say proudly, I Dwight Peku can say proudly, Camille grew in a community that most of us are from, if not all of us are from. And based on my intelligence, I don't want nobody to tell me, acquainted with Camille for years, because I usually live in locally too. When I move come to Central Village, that's the first place we live, not you? Yeah, man, you live in the same yard. And Camille is one of those coming to person you can point finger upon and say she's this and she's that. Never. She's one of those young ladies that stand out in spite of what she see happening around her, in her circle and all of that. I can proudly say that you can't point your finger on Camille in a negative way. A negative way or so. Because she stood out and continued to stand out. And Madam 50, congratulations. Keep on keeping on. Keep on doing what you're doing. Then, Mr. Solomon, why you turn it up? You know why people have him? All right, we have a big mouth. Keep on doing what you're doing so that the person to your left could have the privilege to see you and look at you.
Check. Oh. So I'm having a spirit of work.
Yes. See you and look at you. And this evening, when I sat in the vehicle and I saw him, came out. And I saw him fix him jacket, you know. I says, oh, and this is the man. You see? And then to confirm it, I saw when Michelle Bill went over and having a word with me, said, yes. Say, Mrs. Francis, yeah, man, I'm on that. Then when I saw her, came on the vehicle, and I saw her color, and his color, I said, done. I said, I hope I'm not married, I'm not married yet tonight. You see? So, ladies and gentlemen, the floor is open now for you to give your toast before we cut cake and do what we have to do. And I know that persons have somewhat to say, must have somewhat to say, because you can't come here if you can't do nothing, the people there food and go and so. Sorry? You can't just come here to eat the people them food and leave so. You see? So all who have something wonderful to say about Camille, the floor is open now for you to come up here. Make the video light shine on you.
First, I'd like to thank everyone for coming out tonight for my auntie's 50th birthday. I'd just like to say thank you to my auntie for all those years of raising me and my cousins and literally being a mother figure to each and every single one of us since we were little. And for you to be able to reach 50 at this age right now, we're so happy for you, and we all love you. And we all come out here to like drink, party, and have fun with you. You know, and literally words can't even explain how much we just love and appreciate you so much that literally, sometimes I literally pray and I burst out in tears sometimes when I think about how you even raised us, because you raised us all right. And so as we come out here tonight to just say thank you and praise the word of the God that you're still here with us and that you're mixing and mingling with the family still. And look at how many people come out just to say happy birthday to your auntie. Just, we all love you.
Yeah. You deserve a better round of applause.
Well, I would just like to say happy birthday, Auntie. 50 years old. 50 years old. I remember the time when Mommy left us with you, and I wondered how you would take care of three kids, but you did it. Thank God you did it. From, I didn't even know I would be able to come to Jamaica to come see my Auntie's 50th birthday, but God make a way.
Yes.
Thank you, Auntie Tito. Thank you. Happy birthday, 50 years old.
You remind us of that nickname, Tutu. Yeah. my heart moved just now. It is wonderful when you can say what you have to say while persons are alive. You show your appreciation, show that you really, really, really appreciate what they did for you. I remember them. Someone and come in, now leave them, you know. And you wish you are going, you know.
And bad.
They, you know.
And bad.
And, well, it's nice to see you talking up now. But you see, she's not leaving them. And if you didn't know that, it's not her biological children. You just want to know. Because these children stick to her, everything. It's like when we have meeting and Camille come to meeting and Camille, definitely, I have to go home, you know, because it's a boy and that and that. You know, I recall when Simone was leaving, I recall. And Camille just said that Camille is going to take care of them. Knowing the type of person that I know Camille is, and still is, was and still is, I know that she would have done a splendid job. But to grow, this must be said, to grow boys in a community like what we know, and see that they hold up the head, and don't go down a certain road, she must be commended. Yeah, man, you need to say that, because these young men now, but they were boys then. They could not alter them with. Come out the house, certain hours are built out there, whatever, whatever. They could, even if they have it in their mind, they couldn't move because Camille have them under heavy balance. You see? And the beauty about it, they didn't disrespect her. They didn't show any sign of saying, you can't talk to me because you're not my mother.
No, no.
You see, they stood up and look at them now. I saw a picture on social media with them and I said, what, wait. Maybe if I didn't see that picture, maybe that passed them from the road. I said, wait, it's not them. I was looking on the picture. Remember, say, me and your friend from social media. You see, well, God bless you boys, young men. God bless you. Anybody else? Mostly. Yeah, man, you have to talk, man. We have to talk, man.
Hi, good night, ladies and gentlemen. I consider it a real pleasure and a privilege to be saying happy 50th to Camille. I started working Central with, what year was it? I don't remember.
Long
years
time.
Ago, I was working with the Jamaica Social Investment Fund, and we had a project out there, and that's where I met Camille. And that time, Natalie, my heartbeat, she was there also. And when Camille came to the first meeting, and I said to Natalie, boy, she looks serious. You know, I said, she looks serious. But then I got to know Camille. And we did a project with her. You remember those things that you made, Camille? Excellent project. And they went all over IOM, the International JCF. Went all over, both in Jamaica and abroad. And everybody loved it. But I remember most about Camille. Like every time I call Camille, I said, Camille, you still have that fridge? Because we were starting up businesses in the community. And Camille was one of those persons that we gave this fridge to start a little business. And up to last year I spoke to you, Camille, and you still have the fridge. I can't believe that. Most persons, we gave goat, we gave pigs. By the time we turned on the pig, then dead, the goat, them dead. Nothing came out of it. But Camille's project was something that we could talk about at JCF. And I really want to commend you, Camille, forgive me, and to just wish you all the best. One of the other things that I admire about you before I go is how the young men that you raised and that little girl, your sister, where is she?
Shirley Figueroa.
Hey, little baby, yes. Yes, right, oh, she raised them and oh, she took care of them. And I know that there's a place up in heaven for you, Camille. I know that there's a place there for you because you are so kind. It is not about just praise, Lord, praise God and going on. It's the things that we do that the Lord is pleased about. And I'm quite sure that he is quite pleased with Camille. All the best, Camille, and may God continue to bless you.
The young miss.
Kimora, let's go.
I recall and I remember. Boy, she cried a lot. But Camille not leaving her. Not leaving her. And look at her tonight. My God.
Come, Kimora, let's go.
She come in? Yeah, or she's still
she
shy.
She gotta say something.
Kimora, your auntie's waiting on you. She calling her.
Go.
I know. Well, she grew out of it. Our mommy's coming to take her. Our mommy's coming to the bank.
I'm going to talk for Kimora now. All right. I left Jamaica 2013, September 9th, to be exact. And I remember when I told my sister this lie, because I started falling for myself to Canada, and then I got pregnant with Kimora. And when I got pregnant, everybody know that I was doing the paperwork. And I remember going to my sister's house. I don't want to cry. And I said, I supposed to do medical now, you know? And I'm pregnant. And she said, oh, you look so. That's a good thing. It's like she wants it. Let me carry it for you then. And when she said that, my body get warm. And I think that time, spiritually, emotionally, she touched Kimora, because Kimora don't look nothing like me. Kimora look like her. And I told her, my friend from college, gonna get a job. No, this time I do have about the paperwork, and I said, me not tell nobody. As close as she is with me, I tell her, I said, Georgia, get another job for me in Montego Bay. And if it come true, she will keep the kids, and she say anything for you. And I said, okay. When I pick up everything from the embassy, and I said to her, well, look for my bed, you see something. And when she look, yeah, go back a foreign. We said, look out visa, a different country. And she said, a lie. And we say, yeah, man, I'm leaving. And you say, you're going to keep the kids. And she said, okay. And I left. I know that I just carry those kids in my belly. Because even when I came from U.S. with William, and I couldn't hardly make it, she said, can you pick me to my central village? And yeah, really go and go where? Yeah, teacher, William, soldier. Then I left Kimora at 2. You understand? And even when she come up, sorry, when Jesse was a baby, she said, give me Jesse, man. And I said, no, a time for you to live your life. And I said, all of this to say, that although my mother died when William was 8 months, my sister replaced my mother. Physically, emotionally, and be honest. Even if I tell my other sister them, every day I have to talk to her. Every day I have to talk to Tutu. I ask her, what if I do? With this, with that, even when the kids are sick of foreign, she tell me what I do, same way. So I mean, carry them, but I fear pity them. Yeah. You understand what I say? And this is just that what we want to show you. When, and me, I speak from my heart. Me don't want you to worry yourself. Because she called me and she said, open yourself, my mola hurt me. Best believe it, tomorrow my mola hurt me too. Mm-hmm. You understand what I say? Me don't want she stress. Me don't want, because me don't know what me that do. You understand? because she had my right, my left, my side. She had my husband, my sister, my mother, my best friend, my everything. And this is just a token. And I can't talk for now till the morning, till next year. Tutu, Camille, listen, I love you. Bad, 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 bad.